How you been? How's everything?
Good to see you. I don't want to talk
to you. Okay. Josesito, are you still bike riding sometimes?
Yeah, not as often as I was before, but yeah, I do. I mostly bike ride in OC.
Do you enjoy it?
Yeah.
Do you take your bike to the OC one way, or do you drive there and then bike?
No, I haven't done that, even though there's the road that can get me straight there, and I don't live too far away from the road, too, so... but no, I ride with the crew over there, with the bike crew, with some Colombians.
Nate Diaz likes to bike ride a lot.
Colombians, I leave. My dad's in Colombia. I don't know. All these connections are a little weird.
Hey, is he bringing back any Colombian fighters?
No. Bringing back product.
Coffee. They make coffee. Colombian coffee, right?
Yeah.
Everywhere I go to 7-Eleven, it says Colombian.
Well, it'll be in coffee.
To throw off the scent from the dogs at the airport, they say coffee, because coffee throws off the scent of the other stuff. Is it true that Joe Rogan is worth $30 million? Did you see that?
He's worth a shitload of money, but I don't know how much.
He's not worth $5. I wouldn't pay to watch him. Sorry.
Ellie's worth $30 million.
Hey, the internet says I'm worth $380, to be honest with you.
You're worth a lot, Ellie.
One time, look.
Did you know Ellie's wedding was at the Four Seasons Hotel in Beverly Hills?
Pita was there.
You gotta be somebody to even get booked there.
What else do you remember? Do you remember the girl walking around giving out cigars? Or
I remember everything. Really.
The fire dancers, or you missed those?
No, I was there for the dancers.
They were fire dancers.
We're sitting with the wine.
Oh, did you see the girl doing...
Yeah.
Did you see the girl doing gymnastics at the wedding, by any chance?
That's all of that shit.
So she's going to the Olympics.
Oh, really? Oh, shit. You told me she was on the Russian Olympic team or something like that, or something.
No, she's now in the U.S., but the other one was Russian.
I misunderstood.
Ukrainian. Ukrainian Olympic team is...
Misunderstood.
Fire breathers too? You had fire breathers there?
Yeah, everything. And people on stilts, it was like Cirque du Soleil wedding. The mayor of Beverly Hills swung by, the owner of the hotel came by. Dude, did you know in Beverly Hills you can't park overnight? Because I parked overnight on the street, I got a ticket.
Oh, really?
Yeah. No, I had a parking pass for the city, but it's only good till 2 a.m. 2 to 5 a.m., you need a different parking pass. So,
Ellie's loaded.
People can't drive in Beverly Hills.
Just so they know.
People respect money. There's money Mayweather and there's money Seckbach.
That sounds good.
They say Ronda Rousey gave me the ticket. She should have posted something about Kobe. I'm sorry. I know she knows a fan. Listen, she has 8 million followers, 12 million followers.
Doesn't matter. Everybody heard about it. Like they needed to hear it from her.
Acting like nothing happened is not cool.
No, she had family. She was close to the family. She talked to them herself.
How do you know?
I'm not saying.
You're estimating.
I'm just saying, what if she did do that? Then you can't.
Then, okay. I seriously doubt that was the case. Yeah, he did. He posted a lot on his Twitter. I follow him on Twitter. You don't follow him on Twitter, Pita.
No, I don't follow him.
And he deleted all his Instagram, so it's not like you could have seen it. He just his Instagram, Al Javante with two A's.
Why did he delete his Instagram?
I don't know.
All that stuff with his baby mom?
I don't know.
Yeah, he's going on Instagram.
Pita, Javante versus Ryan, what do you think if it happens at the end of the year?
Ryan wins.
You think Ryan wins?
Yeah.
What do you say?
I haven't really seen enough of Ryan. Javante's bad.
Decision or knockout? What is your prediction?
Knockout.
You heard Pita. Pita thinks Ryan knocks out Javante. Josito, you ever trained near Edwin Valero? You ever seen him live?
Yeah, I sparred him for a camp.
No.
That was his chief sparring partner.
You were the chief sparring partner at Valero?
Oh, shit.
Did you ever knock him out or drop him?
How hard did he hit?
No, but cool story. The first time I go to spar him, me along with like four other guys were there to spar.
He just used one hand.
Everybody's
a killer.
Just did that today.
Yeah,
one of the kids did that. One of the pros did that.
No, me, along with like about four other guys go to spar, and I was gonna be the last sparring partner. And I get there, everybody's getting ready to go. And one sparring partner goes in, one or two rounds, knocks him out. The second goes in, he goes one round, knocks him out. Third one, same thing, stops him. You know, I was like, oh shit, what am I getting into? You know, so I was kind of like, damn, what the hell? This guy's putting everybody down, dropping them, hurting them. Oh, shit, man. So, finally it's me to go up. And, you know, he's fast, he's good. I mean, I was just glad I didn't get knocked out or stopped or hurt. You know, but we had a good sparring.
Hey!
Man, and he was a lot better than his video showed.
27-0, 27 knockouts. He's got to do something right.
Just wild, man. Strength.
Just wild, wild. He was a tech.
He was comparable to Pacquiao. Like,
who would have won him and Pacquiao? 35. Pita?
That would have been good.
I haven't seen enough of Valero to say that.
Mikey.
I don't really watch.
He sparred Valero for an entire camp. You sparred Valero. Valero, Pacquiao, who would have won?
At the moment, I always told everybody Valero would have knocked out Pacquiao.
Really? You sparred both?
Yeah, yeah. But at the moment, when they were both at 30, 35, I just felt Valero's power was just fucking insane.
Yeah,
you felt that too?
And he was knocking out. He knocked out like three guys before I sparred.
Just the sparring, yeah.
So he was thinking, I don't want to spar him. Like, he's knocking everybody out.
Guys, I was like,
I ain't getting paid enough for this.
How old were you?
Shit. That was probably two fights before he passed away.
Wow. Yeah, did you get paid? Before.
Yeah.
Was it in singles? Did it smell like a strip club?
No.
Oh, no. That was somebody else. Okay.
Yeah, but it was mainly else. The work. I wasn't even getting paid that much.
Yeah, I remember sparring with that guy too, and he hit the hardest that I've ever felt.
How, like, what did it feel like? What do you like?
It just hurt. It just
like
just,
a 2x4, like a brick.
I've never been hit by a 2x4 or a brick, but he was fucking hard, dude. It was
a small guy, 135, wasn't it?
30-35, you know, but he fucking hit hard. Yeah, I remember they talked about maybe a fight with Pacquiao. I said, this fucker will knock him out,
dude. And crazy thing that he would run from his camp house, probably like 3-4 miles away with a sauna suit. And we're talking in the summer. Get there, would barely even warm up. He wouldn't really do much. It was weird. Just get wrapped up and up to spar.
You know what I heard? I heard that he was OCD, obsessive compulsive, that he would hit the heavy bag nonstop, like for 30, 40 minutes. Just no breaks. Just go, 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 go. Unfortunately, it was an accident that gave him some brain damage and then his tragic ending where he killed his wife and killed himself.
Yeah.
And he was in a country where the president loved him, Hugo Chavez, so he would have gotten clemency. He would have been out of jail, but mental illness is sad.
Yeah, I know, man.
That's crazy that you sparred him. Were you able to hurt him or knock him out or drop him? Or
No. We had good sparring.
Break his jaw or anything?
No, we had really good sparring, though. It helped me out a lot, too. So.
That's crazy. Were you mad at your coach that's bringing you there? Or like, what am I doing?
No, at first I was like, shit. But, you know, those guys that were sparring him.
Thanks.
Amateurs. They weren't
getting paid.
So that was sad. That was sad.
Okay.
Kids learning, basically. They were amateurs.
We're live. They're asking, what's the biggest punch he landed on you that you remember? Was it a hook, an uppercut? Was it straight? Was it...
All of the above.
No, one maybe.
There wasn't really one punch that really hurt me or anything. It was just overall strong.
But Mikey told me he hit a lot on the forearm and on the shoulder.
Mikey said that's where he would feel it, yeah.
Forearm.
He did a lot.
That's
right,
what Mikey said. That.
He went all out on that to make you put your hands down. Did you hit him in the nuts or something? Like,
like to calm him down? Like, come
did you talk to him at all? Was he a personable person or was he in his own world, like standoffish? Like,
no, not conversations with him, no. But he would say what's up when you walk in. You come into the gym in a sauna suit.
That's it. come in. Pita, I'm coming from home in a sauna suit.
Yeah. Take it off, wrap up.
Well, listen, I'll tell you the logic behind that. In Los Angeles, you have crazy traffic. You could sit in your car, turn on the AC. Marquez used to do this. Juan Ramon Marquez, he would turn on the AC to max, sweat his ass off. I never van full of 12 people, and they all would sweat.
Trying to heat.
But it takes 30, 40 minutes to get anywhere in LA during the day.
Yeah.
So that's why it was just being smart.
I would lose the last pound or two as an amateur when I was like 13 in a hot car.
But Josesito, what did they pay you?
Yeah, with the kids. Yeah. Put them in the fucking car.
Do you remember how much they paid you for sparring Valero? I mean, you were there the whole camp.
It wasn't much.
Like, was it like 300 a week, 400 a week, something like that?
500.
That's not bad.
For sparring 3 days a week.
That's pretty good, actually. Right, Pita?
What is it?
500 for 3 days a week. But it's not good for punishment.
No, but I didn't really go there for the money. I went there for the experience, for the work. I was
when you're a young guy, that's
there was no Instagram, no Facebook, no YouTube. You couldn't really milk it like today. Like somebody, if you spar a big name, you could take a picture with them, a selfie.
Yeah, but it was just to get for him to get better.
Yeah, I know there's
look.
I've met some heavyweights that make a living off being sparring partners. They're just sparring partners.
Just with the experience, Ellie.
Yeah, no, it's true. You have a spar Pacquiao?
No.
You have a spar Mayweather?
No.
You have a spar?
I was supposed to spar. I was supposed to spar Juan Manuel Marquez in Big Bear.
What fight was he getting ready for?
No. I forgot which fight he was getting ready for, but I was young crow. And as soon as I got there, I had just fought. And I got there, they weighed me in and said, no, you're too heavy. And I wasn't even that heavy. That was light. And no, you're too heavy. They gave us some gas money.
Well, he's a smart guy. You know what? Give him credit. He's on top of his craft. Other fighter would say outspar anybody, and then. But the fans are asking any updates about Josesito. Anything interesting coming up, or just wait and see.
Wait and see, man. Something soon. It's coming.
Stay tuned. So there you have it. Josesito Lopez.